And good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jay Cashmere. We are discussing details of the governor's major announcement yesterday regarding the reopening of Florida. It's my pleasure to welcome into the discussion today Lieutenant Governor Jeanette Nunez. Lieutenant Governor, thanks for joining us today.
Always a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Let's talk about the reopening. You and the governor and the task force and the roundtable discussions have been meeting round the clock. What are the most important points in your mind for reopening the state?
Certainly, as you mentioned, the task force met last week. We had over 20 hours of testimony from industry leaders, experts throughout all of Florida's economy, really. And what we heard was a tremendous amount of focus on how do we get Florida's economy open up again, but doing so in the context of safety and health. And so that's something that was very important for the governor. He wanted to make sure that whatever decisions he made as it relates to opening up the economy were done with key evidence and factors based on our data. What are those key factors? Primarily what we see is our positivity rate. That is the rate of individuals that that receive a positive diagnosis. So that positivity rate has been roughly in the area of 4 to 6%. And so that's something that is an excellent indicator. What they've told us nationally is that the benchmark is somewhere in the neighborhood of 10%. If you look at New York and New Jersey, it's depending on the day between 20 to 30, was as high as 45%. So we're clearly in much better shape than those two states. And so our benchmark is not just the positivity rate, but also hospital capacity. And so all of those things formulated the public health data that allowed us to make the decisions that the governor announced yesterday for the reopening of Florida's economy in a gradual way.
And when you mentioned gradual, the first thing out of the gate yesterday that the governor mentioned was that Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach County would not be part of phase one just because of the clusters. Up to 60% of the infections were down here. Can you give us an indication of when Palm Beach specifically will reopen? Are we talking days, weeks, perhaps Memorial Day?
It's important to note also that for the portion of the order which apply to hospitals and elective procedures, those are indeed allowed to open back up starting Monday in Palm Beach, in Broward, and in Dade. So the hospital procedures, we did not limit it to just the rest of the state minus those three counties. We felt it was important. We've heard from the hospitals. They'll have to keep a sufficient amount of PPE, make sure their hospital capacity continues to be able to address an uptick or an outbreak. So that was important for hospitals and really for individuals that have been delaying necessary procedures for the duration of the pandemic. Everything else, as it relates to opening back up, the restaurants, the retail, the governor has been willing to work with those counties, with Mayor Koerner, with Mayor Holness, with Mayor Jimenez, to make sure that we recognize the unique situation for those three counties and to encourage and to provide support in whatever way we can. So if it's days, if it's weeks, that is something that the governor is willing to work with those counties, recognizing that they understand their counties best and every county has a unique situation. So we're hopeful that they'll be able to follow suit shortly. We're hopeful that they'll be able to get their economy back up and running, but our focus really is in making sure that they do it in a safe way without risking an uptick or a resurgence in cases.
From the standpoint of a resident, from the standpoint of a small business owner, they're looking really strategically at each phase here. You've detailed phase one. Can you give me some idea of what phase two will look like and maybe the ballpark, the timetable of when we will see that phase be implemented?
Indeed, what we saw in phase one, I think the governor referenced it as a baby step. We hope that the next step will be perhaps not a baby step, but a larger step, but it certainly won't be a full-on sprint. We understand that, for example, restaurants, they're opening up with outdoor seating availability and a 25% capacity indoors. That's a challenge. We recognize that many restaurants will have a challenge in being able to open back up under those constructs. But we also recognize that phase two will probably provide some more flexibility. Will it go up to 50%, 75%? I think that remains to be seen. We are going to continue to monitor the data. What we saw, for example, when Duval County opened up the beaches, there was a lot of criticism. A lot of it was unfair. But I think what we've seen is that there's been no major impact on the Duval County cases based on that decision. So I think we're going to look very closely, again, at the rate of positivity, at the rate of increase increased hospitalizations and all of those factors that we've been monitoring very closely. And I don't know that the governor has a hard and fast date in mind. But again, I know he wants to get the economy back up and running. He wants to provide maximum flexibility to those counties with challenges. But for the rest of the state, we know that there are some counties that have very few cases. And so they're going to be eager to get going very quickly. But again, we're taking a measured and balanced approach, and we're going to continue to monitor it and compare it to the data that we see here in Florida.
And how do you really pinpoint between reopening a beach and then letting a hairdresser go back to work and really deciphering between those two entities there?
Sure. So in the first example, a beach, I think the governor has been very, very positive about beaches being open, public spaces. He feels like the risk in terms of the close contact is not the same as if you were getting a haircut. And so when you go to a beach, as long as you maintain that social distance, as long as you don't congregate in groups larger than 10, what we've heard from public health experts, doctors, and others, is there's really a very low risk in that scenario. When you use the other example of a barbershop or a nail salon, clearly there is a sustained contact for a period of time, and that contact is very close and up, you know, up close and personal. And so that's why we deferred on opening up those types of personal care services for the time being. And again, I think each business is going to take the proper protocols and safeguards, really, not only for their employees, but for their clients. And we encourage people to continue to look at CDC guidelines. And obviously, we want to see all of our businesses open. We want to make sure that those that have suffered and have had to close their businesses, whether it's a nail salon, a tattoo parlor, or just your general run-of-the-mill retail, we want to make sure that they have the opportunity to open as quickly as possible, but as safely as possible.
The governor indicated phase one of the most important bullet points was more testing. He incorporated the mobile labs that will be accompanying the testing. Can you guide us to what we'll see in the future as this reopening kicks in?
Sure. I think, as you heard him say, testing, testing, and more testing. We're going to continue to focus on expansion of testing. Through our Department of Emergency Management, we've been able to secure a tremendous amount of not only PPE, but also of testing kits. And so that was something early on that states were clamoring for. There was a national shortage. We've done extraordinarily well in acquiring those types of testing kits. We've also been working very closely on expanding not only the drive-through sites, which we see in various counties throughout the state, but also walk-up sites. And we're looking at more than 9 counties currently that will have and currently have walk-up sites for those that are perhaps disadvantaged or perhaps don't have access to transportation. And the mobile lab, I think he was very excited to announce, we're going to be able to acquire 15,000 tests through the White House, and that's a rapid test. So that really is a game changer. It's something that's going to certainly help in the nursing home department. As you know, that's been our biggest focus because we know that that is the most vulnerable population that we're serving. And so we want to make sure that there is no virus being brought in, and the ability to have a test on site within less than an hour, knowing your results, really will help curtail any further spread, and it will help develop your isolation strategy.
The governor mentioned building confidence in the public. If I know it's safe to go out, I will go out. Really, how do you build that trust in the public when the economic engine of this state is tourism, when you have theme parks that are still closed, and you know the financial instability that's at stake right now?
I think that's a really important point. And I think that's why we took, again, what he referred to as the baby step. We want to develop that trust with our fellow Floridians. We want them to feel safe and secure when they go to a retail establishment. And so those gradual barriers that we put, those parameters, if you will, that we put in place is really an attempt to help people get that confidence back up, to feel like they're taking the appropriate precautions. They're making sure that everything is socially distanced. They're making sure that they limit the amount of people in an enclosed area. And so all of those steps that we took in conjunction with CDC guidelines and OSHA guidelines and Health and Human Services guidelines, those are all important provisions that we took into account. And so I think what you see is week over week, more and more people are feeling more and more confident that we're going to be able to really reopen in a way that's safe. And so that's why it's so important before we move on to phase two, that we're able to tell the story, to show the evidence, because people always like to see the numbers. And you know, you can slice them and dice them however you like, but the bottom line is that we have been very focused on paying attention to those numbers, those key factors that really tell the whole picture.
And finally, Lieutenant Governor, to the hairdresser here in Palm Beach County that saw phase one roll out yesterday and is looking down a pipeline of perhaps weeks, days, and months without a paycheck coming in. What reassurance can you give small business owners like that as they look in toward a financially unstable future?
Indeed, we recognize that there were a whole host of business owners, Floridians, that were eager to hear this announcement yesterday and were unfortunately disappointed that they weren't included in that order. But we didn't do it capriciously. We didn't do it without recognizing that it's a challenge. And so we understand that they're desperate and eager to get back to work, and we hope to help them get there. And that's why we're going to be so focused on testing, on ensuring all of those individual protocols that we mentioned. And so I think that if you could just hang on a little bit longer, we want to make sure that you're safe, your patrons are safe, your employees are safe, but we also understand that you've been faced with an enormous, difficult economic challenge. And so we're hopeful to get back up and running. And I know that the minute that we open up those types of personal care services, I'm sure that their clientele will come flocking back.
Lieutenant Governor Jeanette Nunez. Lieutenant Governor, thanks so much for joining us today. We certainly appreciate you taking some time with us in your busy schedule.
Good luck. Of course, my pleasure. Thank you.